If you are required to take or are considering taking a first-year calculus course at Laurier, you must first complete the Calculus Preparation Evaluation, often referred to as the CPE. The purpose of this video is to answer some frequently asked questions pertaining to the evaluation. Now, if you haven't taken calculus in high school, the first thing you might be asking is how can you possibly be expected to complete a calculus test? Well, the CPE is exactly what the name implies, a Calculus Preparation Evaluation. It assesses how well prepared you are for an entry-level university calculus course. The format of the evaluation is 50 multiple-choice questions, which cover topics from the high school mathematics curriculum up to and including grade 12 advanced functions. While you may have covered some of the concepts way back in grade 9, the majority will be similar to what you have worked with in your grade 11 and grade 12 functions courses. The important thing to note is that no knowledge of calculus itself is required. Why do we require you to complete the CPE? Many students who perform poorly in a calculus course actually understand the calculus concepts themselves, but if they have a weak background in the pre-calculus skills, they have difficulty completing solutions. You still need to be able to factor expressions, solve equations, decipher word problems, graph functions, work with logarithmic, and in some cases, trigonometric expressions. All those skills that were covered by the high school math curriculum, you need to be able to do. If you have difficulty doing the algebraic work, you won't be able to complete solutions to calculus problems, and you won't do well in your calculus class. So we are being proactive. We want to ensure our students are aware of what their calculus instructor is going to assume they already know. We are helping you stay a step ahead. Completing the CPE will let you identify any topics that you have either forgotten from high school or maybe never really fully understood when you took them in high school. Review those concepts beforehand so that you are not playing catch-up when you start your course and can concentrate on the new material being taught as well as adjusting to all the other changes university life brings. The preparation aspect is probably the most important reason we have students complete the CPE. But many Laurier programs that have a calculus requirement allow for two options as to the entry-level course you can start with. The CPE will also help you make an informed decision as to which course will be most appropriate for you. Refer to the video on entry-level calculus courses at Laurier to hear more about what options are available to you in your program of study. Does that mean the CPE is a placement test? We will not register you in a particular course based on your CPE score. The decision as to which course to take is still yours to make, as long as you have the prerequisites for that course. And you will need to use LORIS, Laurier's online registration system, to enroll in the calculus course in the same way you enroll in all of your other classes. Some of the entry-level calculus courses do have a minimum CPE score as a prerequisite. Again, refer to the video covering the entry-level calculus courses for more information about minimum CPE score requirements. Should you study before doing the CPE? This is a very common question we are asked, and the answer is that it is really up to you. Your CPE score should be reflective of your everyday working knowledge in math. If you are currently taking a math course, or maybe just finished one of your high school math courses, then you should need little preparation before attempting the CPE. If it's been a while since you took your last math class, then you may want to do a quick review beforehand. The sample evaluation is a great tool for this purpose. Once you access the CPE website, which we will talk about in a moment, you will have access to a sample evaluation, which contains 50 practice questions. Use these to preview the types of questions and concepts that we are assessing with the CPE, and to also see how easy the system is to use. Upon completion of the sample evaluation, you will be provided a full solution set to those practice problems. Not just the answers, but the full solutions. These may be very useful as a quick review if you have forgotten how to do some of the problems. What you do after you have completed the CPE is probably more important than what you do before. After completing the CPE and submitting your answers, you will get your grade right away. You will also be able to review your results to see which questions you answered correctly and which you may have answered incorrectly. Identify any topics that you found challenging and look for ways to brush up on those skills before starting your calculus course. What if you feel that your CPE score is not reflective of your actual knowledge in math? Maybe you didn't give yourself enough time and you guessed on some questions rather than working through their solutions. Or maybe you just forgot a few things as you were doing the evaluation and you looked back after and said, "I knew that." Whatever the reason, if you are not happy with the results of your first attempt, you can try the CPE again. The questions will change a bit with each attempt, but we do allow up to a maximum of 3 valid attempts on the actual CPE. There is no time you must wait before being able to try the CPE again, but make sure you review your results on the first attempt to see which questions you answered incorrectly before starting it again. If the CPE is completed more than once, we record the highest score obtained, and that is what is used when determining if prerequisites have been met for course registration. So for example, if you are planning to enroll in MA 103, which requires a minimum CPE score of 75%, and you score 70% on your first attempt, and then 80% on your second attempt, The score of 80 will be recorded and Loris will allow you to register for MA 103. What if you fail the CPE? Will you be at risk of being removed from your program? The CPE is not a placement test, and it is not an entrance test either. Your results will not affect your offer of admission to Laurier. There is no actual pass-fail for the CPE. Rather, certain calculus courses expect a certain level of prerequisite knowledge, which is reflected in a minimum CPE score requirement. Regardless of your CPE score, there will be an option that you will be able to register in. But don't forget, the CPE covers content from high school math courses that you have already taken. If you score below 50% on the CPE, then you will likely have difficulty completing the work in any of the entry-level calculus courses, and you are strongly encouraged to strengthen your skills before starting calculus. Use your high school notes if you still have them. Look for any textbooks that would be used for a high school functions course, or that are titled College Algebra. Such books will be an excellent source for review and practice problems, or consider enrolling in Laurier's non-credit course, Triage, Preparation for University Calculus. You have completed the CPE, but still cannot register in a calculus course on Loris. What went wrong? Unfortunately, we do have to manually transfer the CPE scores over to Loris. This is something we do on our end, and it is usually completed each weekday morning by around 10 a.m. So if you've just finished the CPE, wait until the next business day, and you should then be able to enroll in calculus. Depending on staff schedules and availability, it may take up to 5 business days for your score to get transferred. So be patient and try again in a day or two. You can still register in all of your other courses, it is just calculus that you will have to wait until we have processed your CPE score. Note that your CPE score must be the result of a valid attempt. We have checks in place to ensure students put forth a conscientious effort when completing the CPE. So if, for example, your score is uncommonly low, or you only spent 5 minutes to answer 50 math questions, or you leave too many questions unanswered, then your attempt will be marked as invalid. We are not going to tell you what our minimum benchmarks are to define a valid attempt, so please don't ask. But if you have put some honest effort forth when completing the questions, there won't be any issues with your attempt counting. If your attempt does get flagged as invalid, an email will be sent to your @Laurier email account to notify you of this, and to request you do the CPE again. Make sure you are checking your Laurier email account on a regular basis, as it does form our official means of communication with you. If it has been 5 business days since you completed the CPE, and you are still unable to enroll in a calculus course, and you have not received any email notification requesting that you need to do the CPE again, then please contact the CPE coordinator and include the exact error message that Loris displays when you try to enroll. There may be additional restrictions in place for the course, such as degree or field of study restrictions. Is there a deadline by which the CPE must be completed? There is no actual deadline. However, you will not be able to enroll in any of the entry-level calculus courses until you've completed the CPE. You can still register for all of your other courses, just not calculus. Keep in mind that some sections of courses will begin to fill up, and the number of choices you have for lecture and lab sections will decrease the further into summer we are, so don't wait until the last minute to do the CPE. The CPE opens by the last week of May each year and is then accessible 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, so that you can complete it at whatever time is most convenient for you, even if that means at 11 p.m. on a Friday night. Now, how do you complete the CPE? The CPE is completed through our course management system at Laurier, a system referred to as My Learning Space, or MyLS. Before you will be able to log into this system, you must have accepted your offer of admission to Laurier through the Ontario University's Application Center and obtained your Laurier network account. Use your Laurier account credentials to log in at mylearningspace.wlu.ca. Once logged in, click on Self-Registration from the horizontal menu bar. Find the Calculus Preparation Evaluation in the list that appears, click its link, and follow the on-screen instructions to register yourself. The remaining few easy-to-follow steps required to complete the CPE are found on the course page in My Learning Space. You also have access to the sample evaluation from within My Learning Space that you may want to try first. As mentioned previously, upon completion of the sample evaluation, you will be provided with a full solution set to those practice questions, which may be useful as a quick review if you have forgotten how to do some of the problems. Once you are ready to start the actual CPE, keep in mind the following guidelines. You will need to complete the evaluation in one sitting. That is, you will not be able to stop partway through and return at a later time to finish the questions. So make sure you have set aside 2 hours of uninterrupted time before you begin. Most students are able to complete the questions within 75 to 90 minutes, but some extra time is built in as we do not want you to rush through the problems. If you have any issues with your internet connectivity and your page either freezes or closes on you, re-establish your connection and navigate back to the CPE page on My Learning Space. You should be able to re-enter your attempt with all of your previous answers still saved. Continue answering the problems, and you have just lost the few minutes that it took to log back into the system. Have some scrap paper and a pencil at hand to work through solutions. Calculators are not required. Neither calculators nor any other electronic aids or reference materials are to be used. Make sure your CPE score is reflective of your abilities. This is not a competition. While the CPE scores may be provided to instructors of the various calculus courses, they will not be used in any way when determining course grades. Any final advice before starting the CPE? The most important thing? Take the process seriously, but not too seriously. While it is a mandatory requirement, completion of the CPE is not intended to be stressful. Remember that it is neither an entrance test nor a placement test, and the CPE covers material you've already taken, or that you've just learned if you are currently completing your Grade 12 Advanced Functions course. You will use the results to make an informed decision as to the best option for your entry-level calculus course. This ensures a smooth transition from your high school performance in math to your university course. Even if you've already decided which calculus course you want to take at Laurier, doing the evaluation is still mandatory and gives you a jumpstart on being prepared. See what skills are needed for calculus, and then start off on the right foot by reviewing the prerequisite material beforehand so that you are not playing catch-up when you start your course. If you have any further questions concerning the CPE, or have any issues accessing and completing the evaluation, or require any academic accommodations as assessed by our Accessible Learning Center, then please contact the CPE coordinator. We are here to help.